cultivate buddhicitta. This weekend is a fortunate to put or to have opportunity to put your body, speech, mind, action into part of liberation, into part of, you know, control. It's so worthwhile, so fortunate. Although we have been so many lives, even this life we born up to now, almost we never acting seriously. One day, if we really check up, because most time our mind is occupied by the, you know, uncontrolled mind, with the superstition. So, having enthusiastic feeling, and wanting to help others as much as possible, most of the higher way, and also yourself. Because we know, since we born up to now, most, you know, time and day and month, year, everything waste. Instead of, you know, worthwhile using bring you happiness, and we using a life, you know, a precious life, you know, for nothing, and a useless action. We think useful, actually not useful. You check up. Perhaps you think we do worthwhile because I take care, you know, life, person, my person. I make money, I preserve my life. That is human ability. That's all you can do. If that's all you can do, you are not different than, you know, cave and, rabbit, you know. Such a human, you know, quality, and using, same thing as an animal is so waste time, incredible, isn't it? You have to realize. If you really check up deeper, what you do, what you did since you born up to now, which is really worthwhile, to bring the true happiness and the joyful life. What you did, you check up. You check up, don't look others. You check up your own action. So nothing worry about, nothing too much. You have your body, your speech, your mind. These three. Okay. These three actions, what you did worldwide. Or, most time, if I say truly, the most time our body, speech, mind, action is, produce, more, frustration, confusion. Check out. One day, how many hours, each hour, how you are aware, how you are positive. You check out that way. It's so simple. The Buddhism way of checking, describing it so scientific. It's not just we try something, exclusive, We're not trying that way. Realistic, You check out that. Even if sometimes we say, okay, we take spiritual life or something, meditative life, we are not serious. You check up. Doesn't matter you meditate, you go spiritual, custom, you go Sunday church or temple. That doesn't mean anything. Which action which brings really, which is bring or carry you into everlasting, peaceful, happiness, real joyful state, rather than up and down, such a transitory. All those actions which brings, up and down. There's not true Dharma, there's not true meditator. There's no true religion at all. Okay, I can make statement. That's all. Although we think, I'm doing something. We're always dreaming with a polluted mind. This is the, actually our relative, nature. The Buddhism describing, then you understand, your nature. The your nature has, actually you think, how are you describing? My nature has so many things. What's the thing that way? Buddhism explains so simple. Your nature has three things, category. One is a relative your nature, one is a absolute your nature. So what I talk about, previous, how you are, relatively, that is a relative nature. We often talk about something higher idea, something, maybe absolute, maybe you heard, reading books, something absolute, these things. Forget absolute. First of all, you have to know how the relativity, body, speech, mind is functioning, everyday life. Yes, this is the very important. You cannot jump, such inner freedom, sort of, lie, cannot jump like this, The human evolution of the human mind, scientific, somehow they explain gradually develop. You all know, I'm sure, you have been in school. I haven't been in school. Very poor boy, I'm a stupid boy, so I haven't been in school. I'm not educated. you know. Okay. Perhaps I can say, perhaps, you know, in the West, when we talk about the subject of mind, control, I think maybe you are primitive, you know. Maybe school talk about I'm primitive. I'm joking. Just joking. Although, you know, since you born, you know, up to now, you say, you know, my mind is dead, my mind is dead. You have no idea what is your mind. Isn't that silly? Even if they're using my mind, that blah, 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 blah. But you don't know what is the your nature of your mind. You understand? This is not that something is the custom. You born up to now, you have mind. And you say your mind is the Eastern custom? You going to say or not? You can't say, isn't it? Also, Buddhism not describing something custom. You understand? Custom is not important. So mind is, you know, describing mind is not the Eastern custom. You have already. Although, you know, sometimes we ignore. So now I describe, you know, your relative nature. So relativity mind, everyday life, we're relating with our friend, family, or wife, or husband, or, you know, girlfriend, or boyfriend, or, you know, society, or all the time, we blame others. Check up your mind, check up, you blame others. That is a misconception. The all the your problem, physically or mentally, all this comes from is the, you know, the lack of, you know, intensive knowledge, wisdom, which is inward. And also attachment. This too is, you know, backseat root of problem. Of any problem, the social problem, individual problem. Check up that. But this time check up your own, you know, the, you know, thing. Just simple example. Many times we make up, you know, telling lies, you know, try to cheat others. And also killing, you know, taking others' life. We do, we check up that. Why we do? The root is ignorance. And the purpose is, you know, attachment, involving your own pleasure. Yeah. Sort of, you know, like ignorant. Ignorant is the root, you know, like maybe king or queen. But this is example, you know. Don't think seriously, take political terms, okay? Then you go think, you know, oh, who want king, queen again? I'm joking. Anyway, okay. Like, you know, the ignorant, you know, the lack of, you know, intense knowledge, wisdom, that energy is like, you know, king. Okay. And, you know, attachment like, you know, is like director. It's the mind, your mind. I'm not talking about, you know, something else, you know. Your mind, one thing is association. Your mind is, you know, associated with, you know, ignorance. One is, you know, associated with the attachment. These two principal cause all the problem, physical problem, mental problem. If you not realize these two things are, you know, the problem of human problem, you can never solve the human problem. You always think, oh, human problem is because this not so good, I cut this. Or human problem is, you know, this house is make bigger, nice. You understand? You can never finish it. Human problem is, I don't have big car. Therefore, you know, next year I have to buy a big car. Maybe then I'm happy. That's not true. Yeah, we always thought. I have small house, you know. Now I need big, you know, house, you know. Big, you know, these are my, you know, solution, you know, to bring happiness. It's not true. You check out. So all the time, especially the Western world, you know, always, every problem is getting a solution, you know, if I have money. That are misconception. Impossible. Don't think, okay, Lama said this one, the Lama put down. Even if you don't say, don't think intellectually, inside you deep root, check out this. You understand? Don't think human problem is something comes from intellectual. You couldn't believe actually what you're doing. Inside what you believe in is even if you're not taught consciously. You know, unconsciously walking, leading you there, going there, another tree, then you know, this is just you're doing all the time. Just changing. Cycle, you know. Many religions, they draw a circle. I think not only Tibetan religions, you know, we have circle. Okay, so go this way, then 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 go this way, this way, this way. Never beyond this circle. You understand? We are joking, actually. We are joking. Play. Certain we give talk, you know, they play something like that, you know. Actually, we also play by having different trip, you know. Or especially, we taking it, you know, we learn a little bit now. Oh, yeah. We understand, we learned now, you know, this generation, we learned so much. The social economy and, you know, inflation, those are signature. Actually, there's no really security. Now check it. Now, you know, it's not that you are intelligent. You understand? Not that your generation is something intelligent than other religion, other, you know, old generation is, you know, foolish. No. Why? Because external changing, itself changing, make to see, oh, this changing. Oh. You understand? The world situation changing itself, you learn it that way. Not that you intelligent, you know. Old generation is foolish, you know. Don't think that way. The outside, you know, this outside, you know, environment, you know, since world, you can see easily now, parking is falling. Ancient time, you know, the old people believe that way, now it's not there. You know, you people know now. So you know, that's why you're seeking something which is worthwhile, rather than only material comfort. But if you're not, you know, putting right attitude, you still struggle. Even if you go meditative, yoga, or spiritual training, and still you are like this. It's possible, you understand? You understand? You have to need, you know, right mental attitude and the right path and the right view. By recognizing wrong mental attitude, how to lead you, you know, miss path and miss, you know, and the goal. Because most time, you know, in the West, oh, don't be ridiculous, you know, negative, you know, you should be positive. You understand? We always say, you know, they like positive talk about, don't like negative talk about. Negative existed. Why you don't talk about, you know? Not the, you know, sort of, you know, anger, you know. You understand? Not like talk about, you know, with anger, but demonstrate and knowing how the negative mind is functioning. It's very important. Very important terminology, Buddhism. Therefore, Buddhism is, I said, not just, you know, develop matter is something spiritual, you know, religion. I'm not sure what I'm saying. You understand? Not something said to nice things, you know. Say you exactly, you understand, without hesitation. So you don't shock. So you should expect it, you know. Namako is saying not nice things. I think so. Oh, don't worry, okay? Why? Because we have nice quality, beautiful quality. We have, you know, equally universal living beings, even, you know, fish, chickens, you know, we have, there is good, you know, quality of mind, natural existence. At the same time, we have also negativity, you know, nature, which brings us down. So the both demonstrate to our mind, both knowing is so worthwhile. Then can release fear. Otherwise, you know, each movement, you know, and the action, you know, and brings, you know, fear. as long as you don't have, you know, I mean, inner understanding what is real happiness and what is real joyful life, if you don't have that kind of, you know, understanding, knowledge, wisdom, and expecting, oh, I waiting, world is better sometimes, you know, better. It's you dreaming. How you think the world is become better? Now, good example, inflation, how is better? Inflation is comes from attachment, okay. Oh yeah, that's all. You check up, you pick out that, you know, I'm sure, you know, political people don't know also that one. month, year, they're talking, you know, oh, this. Perhaps they don't know. It is come from attachment. Why? You check up that. Not just, you know, something, you know, economy is, you know, before it existed, something is suddenly come lower. No. The selfish, you know, attachment. But it has too much. You know, and the selfish attachment reason, keeping, worry. You understand? Worry. You know, if I not keep this one now, you know, you understand? Worry, you know? You understand? So, you know, they not spend it, so you know, inflation. It's not just, you know, there is nothing medicine. You understand? Do not think in England there is no medicine. You understand? I'm talking about, you know? I'm not talking about the politics. Do not worry you. You understand? Oh, English, we, you know, now we have no food, we have no money. That's not true. In England, sufficient food, sufficient money. But the selfish mind make inflation. I'm not sure, I'm joking, maybe. You check up, actually, check up. It's not, you know, not necessarily because Lama said so. You check up that. I mean, incredible, isn't it? You check out how the attachment, you know, selfish mind making, you know, individual problem and the social problem. You check out that. And destroying your you know, inner, you know, peaceful and joyful life. Look at, you know, and also, you know, religious war now going on, isn't it? I mean, not only nowadays, you know. Those come from attachment, you understand? Even, you know, I'm talking about, you know, attachment function. Okay, the small two children, you know, fighting one item of the, you know, candy. You understand? It comes from attachment, you know. Not only that, the biggest country, you know, each other fighting, you know, also attachment. And also people who are religious people, you know, fighting each other is attachment. Actually, those, you know, people who fighting, you know, each other, you know, although they think religion is something fantastic up there, you know, the fighting is the action of not religion, isn't it? Just idea, you know, idea. That's all. Those people who war for the religion, they're not religious people. I'm going to say, yes, they are not religious people. The religion should be compassion, universal law. So how can you, you know, by killing, I killing to him, how can I become, you know, religion? You think possible? It's impossible. It is attachment, purely. That's all. Don't you think? Check up, really check up, you know. Now you understand, the attachment is the biggest problem in the world. So my religion is good, therefore I kill you. You understand? Ridiculous. Check up now, I demonstrate you. You can see, my religion is good, I kill you. Incredible, you know. You can see, I destroy myself, you know, now. You can see, isn't it? If that point, you know, if that point, what I'm doing is, for me, religion is poison. You understand? I'm nothing to do with religion. You can see, you understand? I'm nothing to do with religion. You understand what I'm doing is? But I have some idea. Oh, yes, my religion is good. You understand? This idea of religion, for me, is poison. You understand? Instead of medicine to solve my psychological problem. You understand what I mean? My example. You clear? Okay. With this mental attitude, you understand? The having idea, religion is such. Instead of you, it becomes your medicine and useful for you, becomes a poison. Because you are, you know, not acting 1 minute seriously into action of religion. You just have idea, this is my religion. You know, most people are idea, you know, maybe this is my religion. You understand? Somebody tried to burn. Oh, you destroying my religion. Misconception. This is not religion. Okay. Okay. So those people who war, they think this material is religion. You understand? Or those are misconception. Religion is not outside. Dharma is not outside. It's only into conscious of your mind. Even Bible said, you know, people who were worshipping, remember Jesus, you know, good example. You know, I mean, Jesus said fantastic things in the Bible we don't realize. Jesus says, you know, person who, you know, worshipping idols, you know, idols, those things, and they are not following me. In the way that's very true, I think fantastic teaching that one. You know, we all do. We don't realize how the religion is able to lie to put it into action and to solve this problem instead of understanding, you know, church, materials, you know, power parties, those becomes religion. It's ridiculous, you know. So the religion, in other words, religious people don't realize their conscious or spirit. Don't realize Holy Spirit as long as you worshipping atom. In other words, you think something religion is atom, material, substantial, material. You have no idea what is really religion. Okay? Oh, Jesus said perfect teaching in the Bible. We don't realize. So the having attachment and ignorance, you know, produces so many misconceptions in life. In our life. How? Many times we think, oh, this is good. This brings me happy. You check up. That is misconception. And fact, you cause making cause suffering, brings reaction. You thinking this brings happy. The good example, in other words, the man who, you know, what is this? Man who ride the bicycle, the second, you know, who jumped like that, you know. You know what is this man? This man, what is this man? There's one famous man, you know, I think you people all know, you know. He played basically, you know, this, and he jumped certain things, you know. That's right, yeah, that's right. You understand? This day, he's, you know, incredible. You people couldn't believe why he did it. This is his pleasure. I mean, he believing. You know that. This, you know, in this simple way demonstrate a good example. Even himself, you know, each time he do, he complete dead. You know, then after sometimes he decided, now no more he do. But his ego attachment, you know, this is my professional work. You know what I mean? Remember? You remember? I have to do again. So he did again, complete pain. You know? I mean, this is, you know, fantastic good example, isn't it? Why he do this? You know? This is the biggest, you know, I mean, a simple way example. But in fact, we also doing this way. We are deep in the trip, you know. We doing different trip. In fact, we doing exactly similar as he do. Okay, why do this? Misconception, total misconception. Okay, you know, misconception. The whole thing, you know, such, causation, which is, you know, cause, brings suffering, but you holding, this is fantastic, yeah. Okay? Now you realize, you check up your physically how you do, your mentally how you do, you check up that. Yeah, good example. Also, we all, you know, experience. You know, better our own experience, make example. We always attachment to food, don't we? By attachment, having food, eating, with a greeting, we always seek stomach, isn't it? This also comes from attachment. It's common. Actually, food should be, you know, human thinking, you know, believing or food, having food is preserving your, you know, body and the life. But having, you know, ignorant mind, taking, you know, poison food and killing yourself. We all know, you know, you check up most people, you know, dying. Why he dying? Because he eat something, 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 something. And that cause something, something. You know. You check up, you know. I know my life, you know. Why he died? Because blah, 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 blah. There's always something which is his mistake. You know. It's really simple. But you have to demonstrate, you have to realize, not just the idea, you understand? If the you know, meditation, something, idea, sort of, you know, you're doing something true, no worthwhile. It really, you know, scientifically explain how the reality of your nature. Okay, now I'm describing your relative nature. A worthwhile idea. When you know your own nature, your own mind, how it, you know, teasing you, how it brings you suffering, if you know, you know, your mind is cooperating with your life. The most time, our mind is not cooperating with our mind, life, you know, so that we don't know what is life going on. What is going on in my life? We don't know. You must be careful, check out. I mean, you really check up, especially, you know, Western, you know, world. Too much important, too much exaggerated sense of gravitation, attachment, sense of object, you know, sense of world. Too much explosion, sense of world, you know. So the automatically, you know, the kids and, you know, human being is automatically, you know, believing. You understand? This, you know, external world is opposite you, you know, brings you happiness. It's true, you check up there. Maybe you didn't say intellectually. If you check up into deeper in your mind, you almost believing that. That is a misconception deep rooted into your conscience. That's all. I'm not talking about something intellectual things. Forget intellectual things. You just watching your own mind. Deeper, how is, you know, you're believing in everyday life, which is best, which is not best for you. Everybody has that. Don't think I don't have. I don't have, you know. I just go like that. Not true. Not true. Don't think I don't have anything fixed idea. You understand? The attachment, the nature is, has always fixed idea. This is the best thing. This is me. Therefore, this is best. check up. You understand? This is me. You understand? So the having attachment, you know, to this kind of best for me. Actually, you know, the association is the ego, I. You understand? The conceptualization of ego, I. I'm 15 years here. This is me. You understand? The my ego, the conception of I ego or mind, fixing the idea what I am, who I am, that's all. Which is nothing so able to do reality of me relatively and absolutely. Now you check up, now time to meditation. What I talk about, same time you meditating, checking. Lama exaggerating or what I'm saying is exactly, yes. Oh, no, you check up now. Really, yeah. So what I'm talking about now, I'm talking about, you know, the attachment is how the association with the ego, you understand? I ego, the conceptualization of I ego, how relating I talk about. Okay, dear. Okay. Okay, I think you people know. What I'm saying is actually the cause of attachment is actually that comes from the basic fundamental, you know, the cause, you know, originated from the, you know, the conceptualization of I ego. The conceptualization of I ego is actually not existent relatively and absolutely within you, but you know, projection of the ego mind projecting and painting such I am D. Then so much as you know, as long beginning you say I am D, pick some idea, then so much worry. Oh, I am D, or therefore I should have D. You know, I'm this, therefore I should have this. I'm this, I'm worried, reputation, because I'm this. You check out that. So those, you know, you really, you know, the fixed idea, what you are, how you are, which is, you know, completely, you know, mental projection, hallucination projection, polluted projection, nothing so able to do with the reality, which is relative and absolute. Check up now, 2 minutes maybe. Check up. What do you think, what you are, how you are? What is you now? Something concrete, substantial, you know, idea. Something, idea. This is me. Sort of come out. Your color is not you, your eye. Your form is not I. Your nose is not I. Your leg is not I. Your heart is not I. The world is the idea of, you know, conceptualization, idea, ego. Where is? Your imagination, the I ego, with the hallucination, is not created by the, you know, the God or Krishna or whatever it is, you know, or Buddha. It's only created by the, your own misconception. Mind. When you release that your imagination or conceptualization, I ego, is non-existent, that suddenly inside your heart is something, you know, substantial, you know, concrete, it disappears. Sort of heart is sort of into heart becomes, resting rather than restless. Something releases restless state, you know, the energy. Incredible, it's so powerful. And then you don't have, you know, sort of, yeah, tied physical body, you know, and tension, you know, tied sort of, you know, you don't have. there is no self-existent concrete, ego. All the transitory phenomena, your physical and your appearance is the, totally non-self-existent. But you always thought your, the superficial mind always thought you are existent within your five aggregate. So the conceptualization, I, ego, the mind, there is something filled in within your this body. Pi aggregate, there is existent, something I am inside, there is something existent. You always thought there. And you feel also there is something. If you really check up, that only your, projection of with a hallucinated mind. In healing and school, your self and also all the sense world is, you know, non-self-existent. The self-existent is only in a reality. The Mahayana forms Madhyamaka. Even in a reality, also non-self-existent. There are no such things at all self-existent, concrete, as egos perceived. Impossible. So simple example, in other words, if you want, sometimes miserable, it's a misconception. Misconception that produce the miserable, condition. Which is a holding, object, which is nothing so able to do, the inner, your world and outer, sense world, reality. For that reason, Lord Buddha said that all your confusion or frustration, the action or result is coming, is your own action. Not created by the God. God not create evil action, isn't it? In the Bible, it didn't say, the evil is created by the God. But many people misconception, and God created everything, therefore they think evil also created by the God. Philosophically, they are trouble. But not important, philosophical. You have to know, what is saying. Many times we think, many people think, the Bible mistake. Bible is not mistake, you mistake, how you interpret it. Because lack of, knowledge, wisdom. so worthwhile. You know, one if one can discover, you know, all the, you know, one's, you know, the false conception and, you know, miserable action, you know, and experience it comes from the, you know, attachment. And the polluted, you know, the I-ego, conceptualization I-ego, one will realize a tremendous, you know, the energy of, you know, the, you know, tightening, uptight, tight bondage, relief. And also, it's not just that you believe, you just experimenting. And it comes experience. Then, you know, you can realize. But the intellectual alone is we not call it is a realization. Without just, you know, without experience. It's a dry. You know? We all been, since we born up to now, we dry, you know. If we not actualize, you know, not have experience, when we're still going dry, you know, and we're going dry with a dry truth. Dry, you know, dry wood. Okay, you can see visualization, dry wood. Oh, time is running. Thank you. So now, you know, what I'm saying, you know, what I'm talking about, you know, your relativity nature of, you know, your own mind. You see, do not think, oh, you know, I feel, you know, I really all, you know, my mind is garbage, you know. Oh, I'm worse in this world, you know. Don't feel that, you know, by realizing, incredible. This not only me, that the universal living being, you know, problem. Many times I thought, I want to help people. I want to help other people with the emotionally. Many times, I'm sure you, everybody thought, you know, I want to live worthwhile. I want to help other people. Ridiculous, you know. You know, so emotional. To really want to help, you know, is I myself, you know, you understand, should realize. And have, you know, capability, you know, to solve the really human problem. You know, then really, you know, worthwhile, you know, I helping others. Possible not knowing how to help yourself, you know, by not knowing your own problem. Then how can you just say, you know, I want to help others, you know? You're just so emotional, you know? No wisdom, no mental, just joking still. You know? So by having realized yourself, situation, you know, and not only me, you know, in this world, you know, countless, you know, living being has this kind of situation. Incredible, you know, and you know, full of misconception, and this cause, you know, produces so much conflict. And you know, mentally and physically, you know, that mind is a conflict. You know, the energy, mental energy, is, you know, transmitted into physical level. All the sickness also comes from the mind. Sick mind, is manifested physically, you know, and both physical also sick. That's all. So having much compassion, much love. By understanding past through you, then you relate with all living beings. Then good. But many times we don't have compassion ourselves. We don't comprehend, say, you know, ourselves. So how you have compassion? You know, how you love others? Impossible. Just words, you know. It's just emotion. We say, oh, I love you, you know, oh, you know. You know. Past love it comes from started from you. By knowing your own situation, what you are. Then this kind of, you know, seriously, sincerity coming, within you, and then sincerely, you know, love to others. Otherwise, we're still joking. The most of our love is selfish attachment, okay? Purely attachment. Perhaps sometimes your meditation is maybe not attachment. The most, even your meditation also, you know, most time is selfish attachment. Check out, you really check out, you know. I'm not joking. I'm not come for joking. True. As long as you too much can claim it, your own, you know, comfort and your own something, you know, concrete, something grasping, that's still selfish, you know. Even if you are spiritual trip, you know, meditative, still selfish. So why I talk about this, you know, emphasize? Because even if you are meditative, the psychologically, you know, effective for you, and you are posted easily, you know. Because you're looking something, you know, concrete for you. Still self-cherishing, even if you are spiritual trained. You know. You understand? Still you have fixed idea, in other words, you know, the conceptualization, egos, you know, the fixed idea, you know, I'm this, my realization is this. Which is totally nothing so able to do true realization. So what the one, by realizing your own situation, you know, situation and lifestyle, it's not something philosophical point of view. Just you check up how your life is, how your way of thinking is, you know, how you mistake, how misconception is related, how you check up that, how attachment is related. By realizing this, you know, instead of worry your own, you know, all universal living with this problem. Then the automatically, you know, intuitively, the compassion and the love is intuitive. Even if you are biggest the enemy, you know, maybe, you know, having this understanding, you know, yesterday is sort of, you know, even don't want to see, visualize, you know, and maybe, you know, next day he becomes beautiful for you. It's true, because of your projection. Actually, you make outside people, he's ugly, he's good, he's bad. Actually, your mental projection, who is absolutely good in this earth? Who is? You tell me. Who is absolutely beautiful in London? Who is absolutely ugly in London? Who is? You cannot explain me, for sure. You check up that, it's really, you know, you check up, that's interesting, isn't it? I'm talking about scientific, you know, fact, you know. I'm not talking about something you believe in, you know. You tell me, scientifically, you tell me, this is absolutely beautiful in London, you tell me. If you are wise. No, I'm joking. Okay. Actually, check up, you know. It's worthwhile, dear. You know, really check up, you know. We go always, you know, we're not checking. We always go just easy. That is the lack of, you know. This kind of, you know, is we call selfishness. Selfishness, isn't it? And also lack of intensive knowledge, wisdom. That nature is. Like that, you know? Okay? All right. So, I think it's the time to break in making pee-pee, okay? Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. We see you again. Thank you. Thank you. Please go. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, 15 minutes maybe, then we see you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. The mantra has a power. Mantra has a power. to distinguish it, your body, speech, mind, from the, you know, mundane, ordinary, you know, thought. So the automatically mantra, you know, having mantra vibration, the automatically mind brings, you know, together, integrate, you know, into one continent rather than split. So the mantra has, you know, power. Therefore, we do some part of, you know, mantra to be able student, you know, have, you know, sort of mind bring together rather than mind, you know, running in, you know, the London, you know, street, you know. I'm joking. Okay, so very useful. Okay, that's the reason, you know, using, you know, purpose is. Okay. And also, Om means, you know, magnificent, you know, knowledge, wisdom, and the power. Uh-huh. And Muni, is, you know, control, you know, great control, or conquer, great conqueror, greatest conqueror. There's three things, okay? So, very useful. We all need, you know, conqueror, you know, uncontrolled mind, isn't it? You know, we don't need to conquer, you know, other sentient being. Need, you know, conquer our own, you know, uncontrolled, you know, mind. Okay, so connotation is sort of, you know, like that. Mm-hmm. So very useful, you know. Okay, anyway, this, you know, breathing. Just, you know, that's all. Bayanda Omone 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 Dayata Omone 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 Dayata If all the negative action and unhappy feeling is comes from false conception, then how to purify it, how to relieve the false conception is only perceiving, you know, right view. The perceiving right view is not just something, you know, instinctively, you know, perceiving, you know. It takes time to develop, have right conception, and perceiving right view is it takes time. For that reason, we need meditation. Order to awaken, you know, or becoming conscious. Most time we think we are conscious, and still actually we are unconscious. You check up, you know, real check up. So the by developing, you know, meditation. So slowly, slowly, you integrate your mind, you know, into, you know, the object of reality. By gradually develop, and also, many times we meditate, you know. Meditation has much obstacle, trouble, and frustration. Is that there is, you know, obstacle. The nature of mind is actually character, absolutely, you know, our nature of mind is, you know, killing clear nature. Clear like nature, you can say. But relatively, you know, the sky is cloudy. When the sudden, you know, the movement, you know, the wind and take, you know, the cloudy, the appears, you know, clear nature of sky. The same thing, exactly same thing, that, you know, the example. Our mind is, you know, the nature of mind is, you know, actually, you know, clean, clear. But the obstacle is, you know, misconception, is, you know, obstruct to be able to see reality. And so, even our meditation always, you know, there is something obstacle and unclear. In the meditation, cannot concentrate, you know, one point in it. And those are, you know, instead of disappointed, that we using metal to purify it, you know, purification metal. We using in Tibetan, you know, Mahayana Buddhism. You should not push, you know. When the meditation is, you know, the mind is not, you know, sort of, you know, fundamentally, you know, not, you know, smoothly, you know, going. Time dead, you should not push, you know. Mind like baby. Baby, you know, baby. Baby pushing, baby don't lie. Remember? You know, we all know, isn't it? We treat men differently, baby, you know, sort of pushing. And we make sort of psychologically, you know, play a little bit, you know. Then baby, okay. The same thing. We have to play with our mind a little bit, you know. When the time, you know, impossible, you know, sort of, you know, that time shouldn't push, you know. Instead of pushing, okay, you know, live there. Okay. Then make some purification meditation. And it becomes, you know, obstacle less, and it becomes more powerful. I think many people do, you know, sort of pushing. Then they become, you know, aggressive, you know, and frustration, and then, you know, angry with friend, you know. Oh, I don't like this morning. I don't have good meditation. Instead of meditation make calm, clear, you know, meditation make me, you know, uptight. You know, and this is the not skillful wisdom. Not having skillful wisdom, how to put together. And also, every time if you do meditation, cultivate Buddhism, totally dedicate, doesn't matter, you know, is good or bad meditation. Whatever I do meditation, this energy is not for me, beneficial, totally other sentient being. If you have dedicated, you know, mind, even if you don't have meditation, you're not disappointed, you know. You know, whatever I've done is for benefiting others. That automatically, you know, you are relaxed, even not, you know, successful. However, my way, I try. Even if I'm not successful with, you know, my, you know, attitude, you know, right attitude, you know, rather than only concerned, I'm miserable, I want happy, you know, therefore. There, you know, that doesn't work that way. Then really becomes disappointed. So therefore, that any action in your meditation before you dedicate and cultivate Buddhism is an incredibly important thing. Even not meditating, even just going your walk, you know, the most time, you know, in this country, everybody is walking somebody else, you know. Somebody else's job, you know, working. So, and you know, before the going walk, you dedicate my life today is beneficial, you know, worthwhile. Then there is no frustration. If only you concerned, you know, your own pleasure, you know, selfish motivation, even your walk, you know, others is always, you know, trouble. Mind is sick here, not happy. You understand? Then becoming uptight with, you know, who are charged that work. Okay, doesn't matter. So it's very important thing to you. Do not think just sitting, this is important. Concentrate, It is important, but not this, everything. Not this everything. All the time, all the time. No matter you are meditating or you are walking or you are walking street or you are walking something, doing something, everything you cooking and making soup, everything is, having good motivation, pure motivation. All the time you can, take those actions into, part of liberation. That is possible. Otherwise, even if you do meditate, it becomes, wrong action with the wrong motivation. Although you play something, you understand? Going temple, example, I'm saying is going temple, going church, with a negative mind, it's a waste of time. It's not relationship, even, purely some sort of trip. Maybe you don't know samsara. Samsara means Sanskrit words, Doesn't matter, don't worry words, it's worldly things, The mundane worldly, things we call Sanskrit samsara. Tibetan called korwa, as a sago, As I say, like that. Okay? But I don't have this time too much explain, philosophical terms, You have to go to university, if you want to learn that. Okay? I'll talk about just practical levels a little bit. Such short time. I mean, it's just simple, You just experiment yourself, If the salvation motivation, even if somebody said, can you give some cup of, coffee or tea? Maybe intellectually say yes, but inside here, something going on here. You know what I mean, You understand that? It's not the sincerity. It's not just that you're not good at meditation. Because the salvation motivation, you don't have dedicated mind. You do with the unhappy, in other words, you understand? You give a cup of tea with the unhappy, going this way, Oh, I don't like this, You understand what I mean? I'm demonstrating this one, If you have, dedicated mind, very happy, you do things with happy, It's worthwhile, isn't it? You're not bothered, circulating all worthwhile. Even I give somebody help, a cup of tea, coffee, worthwhile, with the joyful, Even a cup of, tea or coffee giving is part of liberation with a happy pleasure. Not just tea is, is good, not just coffee is good, but your, sincerity motivation with much pleasure to want to help others. You happy. This is the psychology, It's not just, related to something makeup, Psychological, Psychological effect, it goes that way. So very useful, dedicated. Yeah, we know, isn't it? I mean, wife trouble, husband trouble, wife, boyfriend trouble, girl trouble, with those things comes from salvation mind. You people know, when the salvation motivation, you are trouble, relationship. You check up that. Not that you intelligent, We think We know, you know. We think, oh, I'm intelligent, I have to angry. You understand? If you check up deeper, it's totally, you know, cherish your thought. Attachment involved. If you have dedicated, you know, the mind, you know, why you totally dedicated, you know, husband, you know, rather than I want, you know, want to help, you know, and a man, you know, dedicated, you know, wife, and help, you know, want to help, you know, rather than I want help, you know. If you have this kind of, you know, mental attitude, you know, there's no trouble. Loving kindness to mommy and son do stupid things, still, you know, mommy think, oh, he's good, you know. You know what I mean, you know. I'm not sure that you don't respond, you know. Mommy, good mommy has, you know, good son. Maybe good son, you know. So much dear son. But he does stupid things. Still, mommy think, oh, so nice my son does this. Actually, stupid, isn't it? You understand? Because you know, why, you know, mommy can see that action is, you know, sort of something pleasure. Because she has so much, you know, you understand? Love for the, you know, son, and wanting son, everything is good. So that motivation is still projecting. If somebody else does, she say, oh, I don't like. You know, that the motivation, you check up. I'm not sure that my example is right. You know or you don't know. Clear? Okay. I hope it's good, you know. All right. You can say, you know, how the mental attitude changes, you know, other people's, you know, behavior, different things. You interpret it such a way. If you actualize, you know, the meditation of, you know, Buddhist, you know, totally dedicate other sentient being, and the mind turning that way, meditate, you know, nobody trouble you. It's very true. I'm not joking. Nobody make trouble you. You know, you can see in the world people are beautiful. The nothing is really ugly, make you, you know, uptight. Because you're schizophrenic, you know. The narrative, the mind, then projecting such thing, you know, on, you know, object, then you uptight. Remember, even, you know, say, you know, the Christianity also, there's heaven and also hell, something like that. You know, terminology Buddhism also, there is, you know, heaven, something like that, you know. And the connotation is different. There are no such things, you know, externally existent, something, you know, concrete, you know, such the plural, you know, Hollywood plural, heaven plural, wood, you know, there are no such things existing. But the mind is, you know, in the individual mind is developed and completed, you know, release such, you know, ordinary conceptualization of I ego. Then, for him, so all this earth, you know, the human being, everything is whatever he perceiving is become for him constant and beautiful. And for him that is heaven. No problem. I mean that is you understand, isn't it? I'm talking about a psychological trauma. You don't necessarily believe such heaven is waiting for you, such hell is waiting for you. Not necessarily believe, but you can understand such, you know, I mean, you understand? Such, you know, the you know, ordinary, you know, mundane, you know, thought, you know, projecting such, you know, pollution, and brings you, you know, miserable. You understand? And having releasing this kind of, you know, conceptualization, and having, you know, perfect, you know, view, and then, you know, perceiving, you know, okay, good visualization, good vibration, and have, you know, healthy mind. I think you can see that easily, don't you think? I mean, so logical. I talk about a logical sense, you know. I'm not talking about something, you know, metaphysical, you know, higher thing. I mean, incredible. If you put it into action, you understand? Into action. What you learn things, into action. Meditation, you put it into action. In all the, your life, you know, all the, your, you know, movement, you know, perceiving, everything becomes for you wisdom. Wisdom, you understand? Appears for you better understanding. If you not put in action, then you know, even you know, I mean, Jesus come, Lord Buddha come right now, appears to you, you know, something broken, talk about you, know, oh, you going to go like that, you know. You understand? I say it, not the Jesus is higher, not the Buddha is higher, therefore sort of you open. No. You have to develop yourself, you know. Therefore Lord Buddha said that your positive, you know, positive action is responsible to carry you into perfect, you know, enlightenment. And your negative, you know, action is responsible to bring you down. Many times trouble, sometimes, you know, the Western, you know, mind, they have sort of scientific something, understanding, evolutionary. So therefore, they think, you know, oh, impossible, you know, human being become, you know, sometimes animal. They think impossible. Actually, possible. As I said before, remember, the sick, you know, sick mind is manifested into physical levels, and physical is sick, remember? Same thing. No matter you look form like human being, the mind is, you know, degenerating, and it becomes, you know, worse than animal, and that, you know, mental energy is, you know, generated and transformed into physical level, and then becomes physically animal sometimes. Possible. Don't think you change your body. This human body is to change animal body. No, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that way. You understand? When your consciousness is separated from this human body, then animal mind is, you know, animal mind is there, isn't it? Animal mind is there, mental energy is there. This is transformed into, you know, animal body. That's all. So right action and wrong action is, you know, the differently, you know, the distinguished by the, the wrong thought and the right thought. Right wisdom brings, right action. Wrong conception brings, wrong action. The human energy of body, speech, mind is so powerful. If we put it, right direction, we have no direction. That's why our energy is split. Life has no direction. You check up how your life is, you have life, the direction is. So that your body, speech, mind, energy is, wasted, not having, the direction. So you should have, a discriminated knowledge, wisdom. What is right? What is wrong? What to do, discriminate? You have to, check up, in your mind, how the negative mind is coming, how the positive mind is coming. You have to have, beginning discriminate how to check up. Without checking mind, impossible. Action itself, this is, how can you say? So okay, I think very useful. To seeking the right view, which is the reality of, your, nature. It is so worthwhile through the meditation. So having the understanding that your relativity nature, which is really uncontrolled and not perceiving reality and having much of wrong conception and it brings reaction and prostration and suffering, And that experiment you take to put into all universal living beings, even anything around you. Meditate now, meditate, you know. All universal living beings, not only London people, all the West, East, all universal living beings, having much compassion or love, as you understand the situation, yourself, relative to nature, which is, you know, really, you know, sort of, almost you are intoxicated with, you know, attachment, you know, mind. Normally we say drink make intoxicated, isn't it? You are not intoxicated by the drinking wine, but maybe intoxicated by the attachment. It's true, you know. I'm using this kind of things because, you know, you understand, you know, what I mean, you know. Sometimes I'm joking, sort of, you know. I'm not joking, actually, you know. You understand, you know. Okay. You understand why my expression, you know. Okay. So you meditate a short time. When you see all living beings, all universal living beings, and yourself is equally same thing, such a relativity nature situation. And then one mind you check up, you know, which is the best way I help for others, you check up. Is giving, you know, bread or candy or chocolate or that's ridiculous, isn't it? That is not sufficient way help. Because, you know, all living being, you know, uncontrolled mind, you know, problem is not, you know, having bread. And the lack of, you know, knowledge, wisdom, which is not understanding what they are, how they are, and relatively and absolutely. Actually, it doesn't matter. One has, you know, having, you know, much material, and one is beautiful, and one is non-material and ugly, and one is dancing, one is not dancing. No matter. Actually, you know, in fact, you know, equally same thing. You know. False conception, making suffering. Equally same thing. No matter king or queen, as long as you have, you know, misconception, you know, and polluted, you know, the conceptualization of I ego, it's totally, you know, I mean, same thing. There's no differentiation. There's no differentiation even west, east, you know. Doesn't matter. The equally same thing, situation, wanting happy, not wanting, you know, suffering, but acting, you know, which brings reaction suffering, with the misconception. So that obstructed, you know, inner freedom. And in a joyful life. And then also, you should think, you know, and this is just a temporary obstacle. It is possible to reach totally, and all universal living beings can reach everlasting, peaceful inner freedom, liberation. It is possible. The obstacle is momentary, transitory. So then you can visualize the Lord Buddha. What is the Buddha actually? The Buddha is the, you know, the universal, you know, compassion, wisdom. Which is only said knowledge, wisdom. Which is everlastingly joyful and, you know, peaceful. And that, you know, wisdom mind is manifested with radiated light in front of you. If you can, you can visualize. If you cannot visualize, you can see, you know, Lama Thubten Yeshe is here. Okay, from Thubten Yeshe, or one can visualize, you know, from Buddha, crown, much white radiated light come. White radiated light come. Through your Shushuma. There is some rocky, you know, a mountain coming, you know, a small river, very powerful. What radiated light with the blissful energy coming through your, you know, Shushuma into your heart, all the your nervous system, pupae, you know, impute of body. From Buddha's neck and the Lama's neck are coming red radiated light into your neck. And the pupil impute speech. Such as turning lion, energy of turning lion and making this, you know, this unity among the, you know, people. From Buddha Lama's heart, red radiated light, the blue radiated light come to sink into your heart. Blue radiated light come to sink into your heart. Your heart is fulfilled by the blissful, joyful energy. Pupae, misconception, false conception. all the your nervous system, body, and the, you know, mental sensation is completely fulfilled by the blissful radiated light. Concentrate on feeling unity of you and the light.
Okay, thank you very much. And then dedicate, you know, dedicate. Whatever you do, there is, you know, energy. Even though we didn't see, you know, the energy or mental energy, we maybe didn't see physical levels, there is always energy. This, you know, merit, whatever you do is merit energy. Instead of doing, I meditate, you know, ego developing, you know, instead of putting that energy and dedicate beneficial to others. Great useful. And then we are not, you know, suddenly, you know, we up and down, you know, sometimes anger. Then we make finishing, you know, like this, you know, we make clean here one day, you know, short time we clean, then again comes, you know, anger comes, you know, or make dirty, then again meditate, clean, then again make it dirty, you know. But dedicate, it helps very much, you know. Then not waste that energy. And also useful, you know. And our meditation is not for ego pleasing, you know. It's really, you know, worthwhile to benefit others and bring yourself, you know, into enlightenment, you know, or inner freedom. Okay, that only purpose, nothing to do with the proud, you know, something I'm that this. That's not important. So very useful. Not necessarily to have prayer. Prayer is not the words. Okay? You have to know. It's just using words. But normally prayer is not the word. The effect is in the mind. The dedication is a psychological treatment, actually. Many times we do religious trip or meditation or, you know, mundane trip or we do. After that we do, we proud. Oh, I did this, you know. We proud. There's no reason proud. You know, there's no reason proud. The nature of proud is sickness mind. So when we dedicate everything, you know, to benefit other sentient beings, to bring into everlasting peaceful enlightenment, you know, and the psychologically, they're not proud, so easy. You know, they're not sort of, I did something, sort of, you know. What, I can't talk words, you know. Sometimes, example, you know, maybe good example. Okay, hospital walk somebody else, you know. Why if you stay in home? Then hospital walk, you know, I'm tired, I'm walk so much. You know, make a wave sort of, you know, I don't know, what if, I have no words, maybe. They say, what you want? You stay here, do nothing. I did too much, you know. Sort of making, you know. You understand what I mean? You know, he's showing. His job is he did tremendous something. You know, big show to you, to why? You know, Actually, there's no reason to show, you know. This is his own duty, isn't it? I mean, I think so. I think so. The same thing. When we did meditate also, there's no reason to say somebody, oh, I did great, something like that. There's no reason, you know. It's just, you know, totally dedicate as much as possible. There's no reaction, you know, signals. Otherwise, we do things, we reaction is again sick mind, you know. Okay, that's why. It's just, you know, it's practical levels we're doing, the dedication, not just something custom, not the Tibetan custom, okay? Good, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Excuse me. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Okay. Thank you so much.